Life sciences can change people's lives and help us live longer.
Life sciences is one of the most important industries in the economy. It's like an imperative for humanity that we have drug development.
Life sciences is undergoing a revolution. Last year was the 20th anniversary of the completion of the first human genome. It took 13 years and $3 billion to get that genome done. Now it takes 3 hours and it costs $300. And then on the process side is no longer the art of drug development, but we have art plus artificial intelligence, data analytics, all kinds of technology tools to make the whole process a lot more efficient, higher yielding, and hopefully costing less.
I think the advances in particular in computing power, and now with artificial intelligence, the ability to run the trials and to do the drug discovery is far more advanced than it would have been 5 or 10 years ago.
The number of products in development has at least doubled over the past 10 years. There are close to 10,000 products in development right now in the industry, which is totally unprecedented.
There's a very large number of conditions that don't currently have therapies to address them, but fortunately with significant increase in innovation, products coming to market, those are being addressed and will be over time.
The limiting factor becomes capital. It's like having a really nice car and not having gas to put into it. To develop a new medicine, it takes 10 years, and it costs between $2 and $4 billion during that period of time.
It might not be obvious just how expensive and capital-intensive drug development is, but there are multiple phases of clinical trials. You're dealing with human beings in a very highly regulated environment.
Well, for a new medicine to be able to treat the diseases that we want to treat, you need to show that the new medicine is better than the standard of care, which means that in a clinical trial, you have to do a head-to-head comparison of the two drugs. Now, to do that, you need to purchase your competitor's drug. And if your competitor's drug, let's just say in cancer, costs $150,000 and you run a clinical trial that involves 1,000 patients, that's $150 million just to buy your competitor's drug to incorporate it into your clinical trial.
And the large pharma and biotech companies really don't have the funding capacity to develop all of the promising new therapies that they're developing.
There's a big funding gap in our industry. Every year, the industry invests $300 billion to convert the pipeline into products, but that is hardly enough. You need $170 billion more to take the entire pipeline of the industry and convert it into medicines that would treat patients. So one out of three products in development remains unfunded.
And in life sciences, it's hugely capital consumptive. And there was real need we saw for private capital. I'd say around 2015, Steve and John and the management committee decided that we really needed to figure out how to invest in this rapidly evolving and innovative industry in life sciences. And I met many of the life science-focused investment firms from venture capital through to growth equity. And we came upon Nick Galakatos and the partners at Claris, who had a particular model of investing alongside large pharma and biotech firms at the phase three level of development of the drug, which is a less risky proposition.
In phase three, you already know that the medicine in development already is safe and already is efficacious. It works on patients. What you need to do in phase three is show that it works for 10 times, 20 times, 30 times as many patients, thousands of patients.
The impact of investing in life sciences, bringing products to market for conditions that really don't have a way of being managed or cured. And ultimately, that's what we're trying to do, is bring to market proven therapies that can meet a need for conditions that don't really have treatment. I mean, we've had a very successful investment in anticoagulants for people who might suffer from stroke. It's a drug that was developed by Novartis that we then advanced through clinical trials, and actually Novartis has just recently repurchased that drug.
And what we showed in the study was that our product was 9 times better than the standard of care in terms of safety.
One aspect we love about life sciences is how large the investable universe is around the entire ecosystem of drug discovery, development, marketing, selling. So we're not just investing at the product development level through our life sciences fund. We're also investing in clinical trials service providers. We're investing in logistics assets. We're investing in life sciences real estate, in the supply chain, in manufacturing.
But at the end of the day, probably the most important statistic is that collectively throughout our careers, we've developed more than 200 products, medicines and medical devices, that are treating patients today. And this is the business we're in, helping people live healthier lives for a longer period of time.
One of the pillars on which humanity stands and the quality of life is in the development of drugs to address diseases. In that way, life sciences is a key part of the infrastructure of the future.